Hello everyone, it's our pleasure to speak for COBOL 11 in spite of the current challenge caused by the global pandemic. Our presentation is also related to challenges that academic libraries are facing in relation to implementing open science and research data management services. In our presentation, we will speak about the context of the need to implement research data management services in academic libraries. We will present the result of the survey carried out among university libraries in Lithuania. We will share our own experience and the lessons we have learned. Open Science Agenda for a better dissemination and exploitation of research and innovation results produced using public funding focuses on two categories of outputs, publications and data. Authors of publications have to retain sufficient intellectual property rights for making the publications open access. The requirements for research data is that it is made findable, accessible, interoperable, and reusable. And it is managed with the principle as open as possible, as close as necessary. This agenda is reflected in the recommendation on open access to and preservation of scientific information from the European Commission, adopted in 2012 and revised in 2018. In line with this document, the Research Council of Lithuania adopted the guidelines on open access to scientific publications and data on February 29, 2016. Most academic libraries provide some kind of research support services, but research data management still is a new field of activity for many of them. However, to be able to help researchers to comply with the requirements of funders, libraries should embrace this challenge. Research data management support supplies developing a network of data experts that are not only librarians, but also come from different research disciplines. Speaking about Lithuanian landscape, I'd like to provide information from international registries. There are 9 open access policies and 11 open access repositories. In most cases, those policies focus on open access to publications, but not data. Since 2009, Kaunas University of Technology Library has coordinated the National Open Access Desk for Lithuanian researchers in the frame of the project OpenAIR. And among other things, we are able to promote the repository Zenodo and guidance on how to find a subject repository. Another recent initiative was that in 2019, we started acting as national node for Research Data Alliance. For this, we have to build a team of experts for promoting the outputs and recommendations delivered by Research Data Alliance. Now I am giving the floor to my colleague Ieva, who has also been involved in OpenAIR since 2015 and is responsible for coordinating the Research Data Alliance national node.
Thank you, Gintare. Hello all. Now let me speak about some results of the recently completed survey on RDM at Lithuanian University Libraries. The survey was sent out to 14 libraries. We received completed questionnaires from 8 institutions, and also a message that one institution is looking forward to institutional merger, and that all they don't feel in the position to complete the questionnaire. Now, the picture that we get from those 8 institutions is quite promising, in the sense that 5 institutions are planning to adopt regulations on RDM within 12 to 24 months. Only 2 institutions said that they're not providing any RDM services, whereas others are, and in doing so, they cooperate with other departments: research management office, IT, legal, study offices, doctoral school, publishing house, and also different academic departments. This diagram on specific RDM services provided by the libraries reflects the previous picture. Most services are part of the future plans, represented by the orange line. Working on RDM policies as group members in or outside the institution, creating guides and search tools for data, data sets and repositories are among most frequent activities. The most relevant issues are reflected in the comments too. The first is the lack of procedures for implementing institutional open access policy. It may also be so that there is a lack of clarity in defining stakeholders' roles and responsibilities in the policy documents. Another important issue is that we do not have data librarians by profession. People in this position have to be trained, which is at least time-consuming, and of course may also require other resources. One of the solutions to address the lack of expertise is through involvement in project activities. At KTU, we were privileged enough to be involved in the activities of the Project Open Air, which is about the technical open access infrastructure for research, and also about the human network of experts responsible for organizing workshops, webinars, training sessions, developing courses and different training materials. These are some examples of looking for extra resources and also synergies between different initiatives. Like a series of 5 workshops supported by OpenAir and Foster was carried out back in 2015. And then another 2 workshops were held in 2019 with a new phase of both Foster and OpenAir. No matter how popular these standalone events were, we realized the importance of built-in practices. The first attempt was that we suggested integrating a workshop on open science and research data management into the annual event, that is the International PhD Summer School held at Kaunas University of Technology. Shortly after that, a PhD course on research data management was developed. And the course is now being offered for PhD students as an elective. In parallel, Data management plan became an obligatory element in the doctoral studies at KTU. One of the most recent initiatives we got involved in is coordination of the national node for the Research Data Alliance. Please note that this is not the most recent version of the network, as the most recent one involves Estonia, Bulgaria, and Romania. Among other activities in the frame of this project were dissemination and training events for different target groups: researchers, research managers, policymakers, and of course, librarians. Our overall aim was to raise awareness and provide support in RDM in the national context by disseminating the outputs and recommendations developed by Research Data Alliance. During the lockdown, we were able to summarize our experience in the recently published book, Cases on Research Support Services in Academic Libraries. Well, it is ironic, of course, that we speak about open science in a publication which is not open access. But this demonstrates one of our principles to promote our agenda by trying to use every opportunity that is available. And here are some more principles we try to follow. First of all, of course, you have to be knowledgeable enough. You have to know the global tendencies and to seek to implement them on different levels. For us, experience of our international and also national colleagues has been vitally important. Now, support from stakeholders needs to be sought. You will just simply not be able to do a lot alone. Raising awareness and competence development on different stakeholder groups are also key, as well as being proactive. So here, let me thank you for your attention and hope to welcome you at least on our website and maybe live in Kaunas one day. We are open to questions and discussion. Thank you.